Welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. The show brings you a matchup of division rivals. It's the Chicago Cubs going up against the Cincinnati Reds. John Ciambi and Chris Singleton on the call. And Chris, we've got an opportunity to watch one of the true superstars of the sport. Number 99, always exciting to see him in action.
And this guy's just a heads-up player, but he's got so much talent, and he makes the most of that. I believe it starts with his preparation, because you never see him give away an at-bat. Boog, 8 solid innings this last.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. One away.
Oh, nothing too fancy on the strikeout pitch right there. Just a low 90s fastball, and I'm not sure he was trying to challenge him, but that's pretty much what happened. Very hittable location. We found a way to just get it by him.
Liner caught it second. Settles underneath it and makes the play, and that's out number 3. End of a half inning of play, and now the Reds will get their first opportunity. No score. Big Daddy back to work. That's towards center. Potter under it and puts the squeeze on that one, and there's one down.
But you have to just hunt for what you can handle.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Two down. And here it comes. Line to second, snagged on the bounce. To first, and that'll do it. Down to the bottom of the second. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Swing and a miss. One down.
Good pitch right there. I mean, he's attacking a location that this guy at the plate tends to have trouble with. And there's just so much information in this day and age, sometimes too much information. But the guys that can take that information from the hitter and get the result that they were anticipating, that's really good pitching right there. It's a good job of the pitcher and the catcher working together.
King steps on the bag. First two batters retired here in the top of the third.
Batting none.
Up the middle, over to first, third out, that ends the frame. Nothing happening there for the Cubs, and we are still scoreless. Here comes a pitch. Cut on and miss, struck him out, one out.
Oh, there's a 3-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
On the ground to the left. In plenty of time to first, and they take care of Reynolds for the out.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air, lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution. But it's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. King makes the catch, and that'll do it. And the Cubs are down in order, and we're still knotted at 0. Left-hand batter waits. Got it looking. Down on strikes, and he knew it.
Well, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat-out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion. Figure out a way to shorten your path to the baseball. Put it in play somewhere, then you got a chance.
To the right side, King collects it, and he handles it himself for the out.
The batter, number 18.
And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Cubs are down quietly. They still trail 1-0. Here's a 1-2. That one blasted deep to right, way back there. Puts the squeeze on that one, and there's one down.
It's a really good swing. He just didn't get quite enough of it to beat the wind. It's blowing in from right field right now.
And the righty deals. The punch out there, and there's two away. Kicks and fires. Slice to right. In there, base hit. And the bid for history is gone. And a 1-2. Got it! Huge strikeout there. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit the home half of the sixth. It's the Reds 1 and the Cubs nothing. Righty delivers. Got him looking. And that's the first out. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch.
It just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. Got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Popped up to the left into foul ground. That's out number 2 with a single base runner. Because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead. Out to short. They get the force, and that is that. One left for the Cubs, and it remains 1-0. To the right side, and that one handled, sends it to first, one up, one down. Bounced out to short, now the throw to first on the run, and that quickly, two away. Man, Chris, a jump throw like that is certainly worthy of the StatCast treatment. Let's see what the numbers have to say about it.
Yeah, these are some favorable numbers, Boo. This is the type of play that showcases his arm strength. I mean, he made it look easy, but I promise you, that's not a throw every shortstop.
Jordan Luplo, the next Cub to hit.
Really good piece of hitting last time. Go to the opposite field.
King should have this one. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They trail here, 1-0. Big Daddy, back to work. Swing and a bouncer. Tosses to first, and they get the leadoff man of the ninth. Lifted in the air. Professor makes the catch. And a couple of quick outs. Down to their final strike. Swing and a ball popped up. And he makes the catch. Ball game. And the Reds get a shutout on the mound.
Well, this game, and he saw it all the way through to the end. Nice win.
A 4-0 shutout in this one. For Chris Singleton.